Is the ZTE Blade A7 Prime worth buying in 2020? Well, in this video, we're going to find out. Hi everyone, this is Kevin here, and this is the ZTE Blade A7 Prime. Now, this phone was launched as an exclusive to Visible back in early November of 2019. And since its launch, it's been a big success for both ZTE and Visible. The phone is currently being offered, and was offered since the time of its launch, in two different pricing configurations. So the first way that you can get this phone is by going on Visible's online store and paying $99 for it. However, you can actually get this phone for free if you swap in one of your older Android devices. All you have to do is enter in your IMEI on Visible's website, so that you can confirm with them that it is a working Android phone. But beyond that, they don't really care if the phone is a Boost Mobile branded device, for example, a Metro by T-Mobile branded device. The only requirement is that the phone has to be paid off and powers on. But beyond that, you can trade it in and get one of these for free. So the ZTE Blade A7 Prime features a 6.09-inch display at 720p. Now the display is an LCD display, and features a PPI of 284 and a 19.5:9 aspect ratio. So don't get too concerned about this phone having a 720p display. It's actually a really good looking display with great colors, and it's also nice and crisp. So I'm really happy with it overall. Sure, I would have rather seen a 1080p display, but I can certainly survive with just 720p. And I especially like how this phone has a 19.5:9 aspect ratio. It's a nice kind of thinner but taller design. Great nowadays for the way that people consume content. Like if you're scrolling on your Instagram feed, for example, you can see way more content without scrolling. But also if you're browsing the web, it'll work in the same way. And if you're watching video content, you can even crop in to get a very immersive experience at that aspect ratio. Now that PPI of 284 is also not bad at all. And that's one of the reasons too why 720p does look so good on this phone. So overall, I would give the display a 5 out of 5. I'm very happy with it and have been happy with it throughout the time that I've owned this phone. And I actually ordered this a couple days after it was first launched, so I've spent some quality time with it already. Now the phone does feature a teardrop notch here at the top, so pretty good screen to body ratio with the phone. You can see on the bottom here, we do have a little bit of a bezel, but beyond that, it's a really solid design and I like it a lot. They really do kind of maximize the amount of space that's taken up by the display versus kind of useless bezel space. Now up in this teardrop notch on the top, we're getting a 5-megapixel front-facing camera, which does take pretty decent photos. The device itself features 32 gigabytes of internal storage, which is definitely one of the biggest surprises with the ZTE Blade A7 Prime. Typically for phones in this price range, you're getting 16 gigabytes of internal storage. Now I understand that even with those phones that have smaller storage configurations, you can also put an SD card to expand that, but nothing really beats already having a lot of internal storage. And if 32 gigs is not enough for you with the ZTE Blade A7 Prime, then you can always put in a micro SD card and expand the storage. But it was really unexpected to see that we were getting 32 gigs with this phone, and something that I really do appreciate from ZTE. Now, this phone does not feature wireless charging, but that's pretty much to be expected for a phone in this price range. We do, however, get a fingerprint sensor on the back, which some phones in this price range don't have, but the fingerprint sensor works really well. It's nice and quick and responsive. And if you're not really big into using the fingerprint sensor, the phone actually also works with face unlock, so you can unlock the phone with your face. So that's a great feature too. And I like that they give you a lot of different options and ways to unlock your device beyond just using a PIN code, because that's pretty boring and kind of a pain too. Now on the back side of the device, we have a camera module here with just one 16-megapixel camera. It's actually a really good camera and takes really nice looking photos. Definitely make sure to check out my full ZTE Blade A7 Prime review to see more about the photo and video quality from the device. One unfortunate thing though is that there's no portrait mode at the rear or front camera on the phone. So if you're really into portrait mode, you might want to look at a different option. Now the device features 3 gigabytes of RAM, which is not bad at all, and has the MediaTek Helio A22 processor. Now the A22 from MediaTek is one of their more entry-level processors, but the Helio line of processors is certainly a lot better than other processors that we've gotten from MediaTek in the past. So I'm pretty happy overall with the performance from this phone. Certainly the performance isn't going to be anywhere near what you would get with a flagship device like the Galaxy S10 or iPhone 11 or anything else, but it still does work decently well. I like that we are getting stock Android 9 Pie with the phone, so you do get very good optimization here, and overall the software itself is very well optimized to work with the hardware to give you the best performance possible. Now let's go over to the AnTuTu benchmark app and take a look at the scores I got. And I got an overall score of 72743 with a CPU score of 31883 and a GPU score of 4074. So what I recommend doing is downloading the AnTuTu benchmark app on your current smartphone and then comparing the scores from that device to the scores that I've gotten here. Now, if the scores that I've gotten here with the Blade A7 Prime are higher than what you got with your current phone, then this most likely will be a performance upgrade. So something to keep in mind there. So I've already talked a little bit about the hardware here, but overall, I'm a big fan of it. Now, of course, we're getting that 720p LCD display here for the front panel. Definitely a really nice looking display, especially for a very inexpensive phone like this one. Now, taking a look at the left side of the phone, we have the slot for the SD card and SIM card. Then on the right, we have the volume rocker and we have the power button, which is a nice red accent here. Then on the top of the device, we have a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack and a noise canceling microphone. And then on the bottom, we have the microphone and we have the USB-C port for charging and data transfer. So definitely a nice surprise here to see that the ZTE Blade A7 Prime does feature USB-C. That's something that we typically don't see too often with budget phones, especially in this price range. But I'm glad that now in 2020, we are getting that, because really, let's leave micro USB back in the last decade, right? Now, taking a look at the backside of the device, we have this kind of unique texture here, kind of like a pebbly look, but we have the camera module, we have the flash, we have the fingerprint sensor, ZTE logo, and we have the speaker. So this speaker is actually compatible with DTS sound, which I'll show you in a second. But overall, just a really nice design of the phone. It does feature a 3,200 milliamp hour internal battery, so you're getting a pretty beefy battery despite a very thin and small design with the device. But like I mentioned, if you're really into sound, then you're going to be really happy to see that this phone does feature DTS compatibility. So just go to the search and type in DTS and it'll pull up right here. So you'll see DTS sound and then go down to the bottom here, tap on DTS sound, and there's a ton of options here to customize the bass boost, vocal boost, treble boost, and certain optimizations for music, movies, and games. So personally, for me, by default, I think the speakers sound really good on the phone. But if you want to do any sort of further customization, you can do it here natively on the device. Now, another nice surprise with the phone is that it does feature 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi, something that you typically do not see with budget phones like this one. So you are going to be getting better Wi-Fi speeds with it. Now, I'd like to show you what's included in the box here. So this is the box that you're getting with the device. So a pretty nice looking box. You can see ZTE Blade A7 Prime right there. Going to open this up here. And you get a quick start guide, which is cool. You get a wall adapter with ZTE branding on it. And you get a USB-C cable for charging and data transfer. So very nice there. You don't get any headphones or anything like that, but I'm pretty happy overall with what is included. I like that we get a ZTE branded box here and no carrier branding on the box itself. So is the ZTE Blade A7 Prime worth buying in 2020? I certainly think it is a very good option. And the reason for that is because you can get this device extremely affordably. I would certainly recommend going with the free option, getting it for free with a swap, if you do have a phone that you can trade in. But beyond that, you're getting a lot of nice features with this phone. And overall, it's just a nice package here that ZTE has put together. What I mean by that is that the phone has a really good looking display. It has this really cool material on the back side here. But then even internally, we're getting 3 gigs of RAM. We're getting 32 gigabytes of internal storage with SD card expansion. And then the display itself looks really sharp. So there's just a lot of things about the ZTE Blade A7 Prime that I like. And I'm just a big fan of it overall. But I hope you enjoyed this video about the ZTE Blade A7 Prime in 2020. Certainly let me know if you're planning on buying this phone and let me know your thoughts about it. Really interested to hear your opinions. But this is Kevin here. Give the video a thumbs up and I will see you in the next one.